This video explains how to enroll for an iCareCard, VX Gateway's preferred debit card program for the United States. Before you enroll, watch this video for an overview of the card program. The iCareCard is connected to the VXLOOP account that you are logged into when you enroll. From a VX commercial account, you will enroll as an organization or business. Your iCareCard will have the business name and the cardholder's name on it. You must have a federal tax ID and a US address. From a VX personal account, you will enroll as an individual. Your iCareCard will just have the cardholder's name on it. You must be a US person or resident alien, have a social security number or tax identification number, and have a US address. Before you start, make sure that you have sufficient funds in your VXLOOP account to pay the VX Gateway card setup fee, and that the status of your VXLOOP account is activated and verified. Let's start. From the homepage, go to Menu, Card Connections, iCareCard, About iCareCard, and Enroll. Click on the Click Here to Enroll Now button. Select your preferred funding option. Click the question mark for more information, or watch this video. If you selected one of the self-funded options, either Keep This Balance, Weekly Funding, or Manual Transfers Only, then you will enter the details of your checking account. Select an account from your list, or select Create New Checking Account to add the details of the checking account you want to connect to your iCareCard. Click Submit and your checking account will instantly be selected as the external linked account. Next, enter the funding amount. This amount will be debited from your checking account to fund your iCareCard. Read the help information if you selected one of the automatic funding options, either Keep This Balance or Weekly Funding. It's important that you have sufficient balance in your checking account to cover the initial funding amount and the iCareCard issue fee. Otherwise, you may incur bank fees. If you selected direct deposit only, then you have chosen not to connect a checking account. You'll fund your iCareCard from your VXLOOP account or by direct deposit from a third-party checking account. Now go ahead and fill out the enrollment form. If you're enrolling as an individual, you won't see the business name field. Make sure your address details are correct. If you can't find it on Google Maps, then chances are UPS won't find it either. Cards that can't be delivered are destroyed after 30 days by the issuing bank. The mobile phone email address field is the address for sending email to your mobile phone. This feature is handy if a family member is the cardholder. You can receive notifications to your email, and they can receive notifications to their mobile phone. Most carriers have SMS gateways which take email messages from the internet and deliver them to their customers' cell phones as SMS text messages. Check your carrier for the address format. Do not enter your mobile phone number in this field. If you're enrolling as a business, you'll enter the organization's federal tax ID. For individuals, you'll enter your SSN or tax file number here. Read the cardholder disclosure agreement, and if you agree with the terms, then click Submit. If your enrollment is accepted, your VXLOOP account is charged the connection fee, your new bank account is set up, the confirmation message has your iCareCard bank account information, which includes the bank name, bank routing number, and bank account number. You can immediately fund your new iCareCard account by direct deposit to this account from another bank account. Cedar Rapids Bank and Trust mail out your plastic Visa debit card. You should receive it within a week, and you'll immediately receive an email from noreply@vxgateway.net with confirmation of your enrollment. If you chose self-funded and linked a checking account to your iCareCard, then you will need to verify your bank account ownership. In about 2 business days, your checking account will be debited with 2 amounts that add up to the iCareCard issue fee. These are your verification amounts. When you have these 2 amounts, return to VX Gateway, go to Menu, Card Connections, iCareCard, Back Office, Verify. Select the iCareCard account that you want to verify, enter the 2 amounts, enter your PIN, and click Submit. This process verifies that you own the linked checking account. You will see the status of the account change to Y in the accounts list. Transfers are now enabled between your iCareCard and your checking account. You can initiate manual transfers from within VX, or if you selected an automatic self-funding option, it will now be activated. The funding amount you entered in the enrollment form will now be debited to your checking account and cleared to your iCareCard account in approximately 2 business days. When you receive your plastic iCareCard in the mail, activate it so you can use it for purchases and at ATMs. Follow the instructions that are mailed with your iCareCard. If you didn't connect a checking account in the enrollment process, your iCareCard will have a negative balance equal to the iCareCard's issue fee. This fee will be paid when you load funds onto your card for the first time. To manage your iCareCard, view transaction reports, and update your profile, go to iCareCard Back Office. If you need support for your card, contact iCareCard directly. To learn more about VX Gateway and how to manage your iCareCard, check out our other how-to tutorials on our YouTube channel, VX Gateway, because we live, work, and play in a virtual world.